should not do wrong things right, ladies and gentlemen. You should not do wrong things right. You must do right things and you must do them right. That's what leadership is all about. Okay? You all are leaders. You are leader now, you will be leader tomorrow, and you will be leader forever. You are a privileged group of people, the best in the country. So you are not supposed to be just doing what others tell you to do. You must have the feelings of what is right first. Remember that. You can always do. What is the difference between a leader and a manager? The leader and a manager, one of the key differences is, or should not be that way, but generally what they say is that the manager is supposed to carry out things right, the proper way. You manage the things, right? The difference in a leadership is that you must manage the right things. First you must decide what is right, and then you must do it right, etc. So that is why I want to convey this message. You all are leaders, not followers. But leaders do right things the right way. Okay, there's a big difference. You can do wrong things the right way. You can do wrong things the right way. It's easy to do that. You follow the orders. Do it exactly the way it's been said, then you will get a promotion. But are you doing the right thing? So that's what we call about ethics. What is the one? I am an engineering student, right? I understand that when I graduate after 1 or 2, 3 years, I become an engineer. Qualified engineer, BSc engineering degree. You're also in the board accredited and all that other stuff. But once you become that, what's the difference between you and somebody who has been working in the field for 10, 15 years? Experiences. We call it the experience. What are the experiences? Mistakes and doing things right. Both. Experience can be things that you do right and things you do wrong. And actually learn from it. Mistakes, more mistakes, right? Then you are supposed to be a chartered engineer. So what's the difference between the chartered engineer and the experienced engineer and the just graduated engineer? Now who are the other professionals in the field? Doctors, right? Lawyers, who else? Architects, accountants. But there are accountants and there are chartered accountants. There are chartered architects and architects. But the only thing of difference between these professions in my mind and a non-professional is the code of conduct, code of ethics. ECSL has a list of code of ethics. So to become a chartered engineer, when you take the oath, you hold your hand like this, they now give you the card also, you are supposed to read the code of ethics. Am I right? Now they give you the card. During my times, I became a chartered engineer in 1986. We didn't have any of those fancy stuff. But now they give it to you in writing, and then you hold it, and then you put your arm up like this, right? Take an oath. So listen to what I'm saying very carefully and get it into your heart. A professional is someone who has agreed to a code of ethics. What is ethics? These are the Western culture promoted activities in Asian countries. But it's a good one. So this goes back to days of Aristotle and Socrates and all those people. Ethics are about the law. Ethics is not rules. Ethics is your heart. So when you become a professional, and a professional chartered engineer, that's chartered engineer is a professional. When you become a chartered engineer, you sign up for a code of ethics. You should go and read what those code of ethics are. And they are not rules. They are not law. The bylaws are the ones that govern the institution. But above that, there is ethics. So most important thing is to look at the ethics and ask whether you believe in those ethics. Can you fit into those things? Be true to yourself. If you are true to yourself, and if you are looking in the mirror every day, go as young people, you should go to the mirror every day morning and ask, am I proud of myself? Because you can correct yourself now. Otherwise, this is what you are being a leader, and then whether you are a good leader or not, we will find out. You see this slogan? Who's this guy? Anybody? Nelson Mandela, right? He is a man with a strong ethics. That's why he lived out 25 years plus years in the prison. He would have revolted, he would have blasted that prison and everything, but he became a different guy based on his ethics. After he went into the prison, he developed his ethics, values. Ethics is all about values. So please understand this concept of what is a professional and what is the definition of professional. A professional is someone who always have signed up for a code of ethics, not rules, not bylaws. Those are little lame. So let me tell you when the laws comes in. When you have ethics, a code of conduct, to make sure that the people follow. will happen. And normally they don't go here. That's what happens at the university also. You are here for 4 years, everything is here, exam at them, power that again, you are right. But if it goes to the heart, you will become entrepreneurs, like one of my colleagues here. You will produce something to the country. I'll come to that later. So the code of ethics is an important part because it is your values, it's who you are in the core. When you're alone, when you become a leader, you'll find out whether you really have the code of ethics with you. Not when you pass the chart exam. You understand what I'm saying? Code of ethics is not the rules and regulations and etc. It is how you believe, what you believe in. When you are in trouble, you have to go back to your code of ethics and ask, am I doing things right by the code of ethics, not by the law? The best example I can give you on this one of the best examples I can think of right now on this spot is, when you become a civil engineer, you put up houses. What is your real responsibility? Put up the house or the building, keep the project plan running on time, keeping the cost down, what is it?
Right.
Exactly. So if you're designing something that the public is going to use, right? Their safety, their benefit to the public, all those things are the ones that matters most important, not the bending moment and everything. Those are given things. So that is very good. That is the key. If you get this into your heart, that I'm a public servant, whether you are in the private sector or public sector or government, you are always a public servant. You are a servant leader. You are not the boss. Your boss is outside, in front of you. That's the ethics you must have. Your boss is not you. Your boss is always the people in front of you, whether they are your subordinates or whether they are your public, whoever, they are your bosses. You are serving them. And you have been honored to do that. So let me come back to my other side of the equation. That is what the engineers must do, young engineers must understand. You are, when you become engineers, you are servant leaders. You are leaders, but you are more than, even superior than servant leaders. You are serving the nation. You are serving the world. So one of the responsibilities of as a young engineer is to understand that. If you understand the basic principles and if you understand the ethics of being honest and etc., then you are good to go. That's what a child engineer should be. Right? Now, given the short time, if you are governed by a code of ethics, right, not just the rules, and you are given the so if you got the night shift or the charter, now in Sri Lanka, since 2017, March 10th, we now have an act in Sri Lanka. This is the second part. The act is called Engineering Council Sri Lanka Act number 4. 2017, March 10th published. It's the law of the country. You can go to the ISM website or you can go to the www.ecsl.lk. www.ecsl.lk. In Sri Lanka, from this day, the act has been enacted. The word is enacted after enacting the Sri Lanka Act. Any engineer to practice as an engineer, So the engineering council, you should go and look at the act, understand what it is. What this act has three objectives. This act has one objective, register all practicing engineers. So if you become an engineer, a chartered engineer in the ISL, associate member in the ISL, or affiliate member in the ISL, they must be registered here according to the law. If not, you cannot practice as an engineer. There are others, you can go and read them. Who are the others? So you cannot practice in the country. Engineering. Remember, it is about practicing engineering. If you practice something else, that's you don't need to be registered here. For example, if I'm 80 years old and I don't practice anything at all and I'm a fellow of the ISL, I don't have to sign up here, register. The purpose of this is to tell the society, this particular person is an chartered engineer, associate member, affiliate engineer, and there are rules and regulations that we will publish soon. What is it that the chartered engineer can do? And what is it that the associate engineer can do? What is it that the affiliate engineer can do? So we have a code of ethics. If you go to this website, you will see a code of ethics like ISL. So you must read the code of ethics before you become a certified professional engineer. If you can't do it, don't become. Double offense. What is the offense? One, you are breaking the ethics, code of ethics. Otherwise, other thing is, you have knowingly gone and broken it. Your role is to bring, become a value-adding person. Value addition, then CEB got 180,000 value addition. about. What is value addition? Value addition is information or product or anything that comes to my hand, my circle, my abilities. When it passes from me, it should have value to somebody else outside. You understand what I'm saying? Simple definition. If I get an idea, or a service, or a product, or anything, when I pass it to the rest, somebody outside my domain, that person must have value for it, and he or she is willing to pay for it. Right? Why am I here in front of you? Because you, I hope you have some value to what I have to say. I have thoughts, it's coming out of my mouth, and you are listening to it, and if you get it right, you put some value to it. Not all of them, some of them you will put a value. Right. In summary, in our country now, there's a law called Engineering Council Sri Lanka. I'm reversing my picture. That is the law of the country. You have to go by that law. It's not anything. Which means, when you become an associate member of ESL, when you become a chartered engineer of ESL after some years, or when you're an affiliate engineer, if you don't have less quality academic qualification, you must register with Engineering Council Sri Lanka every year. It's a mandatory requirement by law. You cannot become an engineering council member, a registered member, if you are not an ESL member. So which means, people who come through ESL are the best qualified people to become engineers. Then, both organizations have a code of ethics. Follow the code of ethics. You cannot violate the code of ethics. When you become a leader, most importantly, you must be very clear to your code of ethics. Having said all those things, the legal elements of it, when the society recognizes you as a professional engineer, not just an engineer, a Vasun engineer, a professional engineer, then you must ask, what am I doing for the country? Because when you come out of the university, your country, society has already spent, your parents, everybody, with the nation has spent roughly about 13.5 million to 14 million rupees to, on the day you were born, the day you become an engineer. That's the amount of money. So you have to ask, if you get a job to go to do a PhD and remain in USA or something like that, if you're ethical, I think, my ethics tells me, that's why I'm here back in Sri Lanka. That's why I come to talk to you. I believe I have a role to play to give some of that in return, in kind or in money. So if you become Zuckerberg type of guy, you simply pay the 30 million and double it up or 100 times of that and set up the university. But if you don't have that kind of money, provide a service. You don't have to come here. You can be there. Contribute to the foreign exchange earning of the country, or contribute to your university or whatever, or give lectures from abroad. So think about those things from the perspective of what you should do for the country. Because you will die. You come from Earth and you will go. I came from Earth, I will go to Earth. I don't know when. I never knew I was going to be born. I will never know when I'm going to die. Never. Even if doctor tells me, still they can't tell me exactly on this split second I will die. What I got is in between time. And the best time is about to begin for you guys. Because you have been always in the Sri Lankan culture. When you are at home, you can't do everything that you want to. You will very soon, now you are in the best time of your life, the university, you are free. And become strong individuals with the heart and the guts to carry it out.